Hello and welcome to a video about Gravity Team Tactics, another kind of military simulation that I play, similar to Combat Mission, and another on the other end also kind of different. So I'm playing a German campaign here, based on fighting during Operation Blau, and the Russians are blue, I'm red. The Russians are retreating and kind of mounting a delaying action, and I have to cut them off in this area. I'm not going to go into too much detail about what I'm doing in this stage here, because this game is basically divided into two parts, a bit like a Total War game. You have a strategic turn-based kind of layer where you play or where you move around your units, and then after you end your turn, which I'm gonna do now, battles will be generated that you play in real time on a 3D map, which is what will happen now. So this is the first battle. We are attacking this corridor that Russian troops are retreating through in this direction. Anyway, we'll see you on the 3D map. So we are now in the battle mode, and as you can see, it basically cut out a small portion of the overall map, and that's where we will do battle. So I can now zoom in, one sec, and then, whoop, here we go. I'm in 3D mode, which is pretty nifty. So it also chooses which of the which of the units I can use in this battle, and let's zoom out again. What we have here is, from the south, I have only one platoon, and I will keep that in this forest here in reserve, just in case they run away from here into here, but later I can also attack into this sector, maybe cut them off. My main attack will be carried on with two platoons supported by mortars, the platoons of Kluger and Herzl, which will use smoke grenades and so on in order to attack into Krasny Pahar. We did already spot Russian fortifications, or what I believe to be Russian fortifications here. So they are dug in this area. I don't know if this might be vehicles, but just to be safe, they will throw smoke. I should tell you though, by the way, these are my troops. As you can see, the graphical fidelity is better than in Combat Mission, I would say. Although, especially infantry animations are, let's just say our new Forgotten Hope 2 ones are way better. So these guys will just attack across this open ground. Before you say, well, that's stupid and suicidal, they will use smoke grenades, and as far as I'm aware, it's actually darker than it seems in the setup zone. As soon as the battle actually starts, it will be a lot darker. So over here, according to the tactical overview, the Russians are planning their own attack. Because of that, I deployed these heavy machine guns here, MG-34s. And they're all along this line here. This is the platoon HQ for them. So if they attack across this open ground, I hope I can mow them down. And I also have this platoon in reserve, and also to refuse this flank here, just in case they attack through this forest. But I kind of expect them not to, and if the situation here becomes serious, I can counterattack with them, or I can move them over to Krasny Pahar. So yeah, that's my plan. Let's see how it goes. Oh, one thing, this is real time only, so it's not like in Combat Mission where I can actually, what's it called, where I can actually rewind and stuff. So I will probably not show you the whole battle, which will take 1 hour, but instead I will just show you impressions from time to time with the icons switched off, and hopefully I will get the most important or cool aspects. And I started the battle. These guys are forming up for the attack. And as you can see, it's way more dark and foggy than it initially appeared.
Die haben die Hosen voll.
Nice, those guys are actually moving out.
Warte.
I also told them to use smoke. Kind of, maybe even unnecessary, considering the...
Wenn der Krieg aus ist,
and there they throw their smoke in, considering the heavy fog. And here we go.
Warum geben die nicht einfach auf?
Na, kind of looks cool. Okay, shots have been fired. I think part of that might be my mortars, I hope. Yeah, that's my mortars actually. Okay. I'm bombarding the Russian fortifications, whatever they may be. Oh, I don't know how... I don't actually know how much of this game works, so I don't know how long they'll be shooting, or like if they will waste all their ammunition on that. Generally speaking, the AI is a lot more independent than a combat mission. Like, you just tell them, go there, and they will do it. But yeah, I'm not sure how much I should trust this. I told them to stop firing. And we call the Russians. Yep, they're dug in here. Yep. Ooh. That was the 5 cm mortars, I think. Yeah, I'm attacking on a broad front here. Okay, these seem to be out of their, what's it called? Out of their fortifications here. You see the tracer zipping around here and ricocheting off the ground. And I also hear fire from over here. Oh, there goes my machine gun team. I think that's the Russian attack. Okay, a little pause here so I can do some ordering. Okay, back on the machine gun line. So apparently what happens is the Russians snuck up on them in the fog. And now I move that reserve infantry platoon into this gap here.
Da drüben!
Yeah. See, there's really close combat going on right now here. And the situation is extremely confused. They're basically past the road already with the shots coming from here. And now I hope that my reserve over here, which I head in the forest somewhere. Yeah, they're moving through the forest somewhere. And now I'm kind of hoping that they will be able to clear the situation. Now over here we appear to have technically captured the village. But there's still Russian resistance here. Russian here seem to be outside of their and we're using the cover of force to them. That's a cable guy. So yeah, we forced our way into the village. Our mortars are giving very effective support, I have to say. One of ours, so it's actually pretty close to our mortar strike. We should probably shift that. Russians are counterattacking, there's actually a major Russian force underway. So I'm kind of hoping that my reserve can push that away. They should be emerging from this forest relatively soon. Yep, you can see them moving towards the front line. The problem is the Russians seem to be using their own artillery here as well. They're murdering my machine gun. So what I'm kind of beginning to think is that I might have to move the guys that just took the village into here to maybe flank that Russian force. I have to say, I did not expect a Russian attack of this strength up here. Apparently they don't like being in trouble. Problem is, of course, over here there's still some fire going on. Especially from the area of this building. Seems relatively quiet. Well, you know, as quiet as the Eastern Front ever gets. So I'm moving troops over, but it's relatively far, and there are still Russians around, so risky business. Yes, our grenade launcher troop for that. Here it's basically an all-out infantry slugfest, and the question is who will win the firefight and gain fire superiority. Morning fog battle, although I think the morning fog might soon be over. off the mortar, you know? Throwing it in there, you know? Good on this flank. Now over here, because of that, well, for one thing, there's still Russians on the other side of the village. They are fighting now. And one platoon is moving across the open here to get into their flank. We have spotted an artillery battery here, which is now under our mortar fire, obviously. And that one southern platoon that used to be in reserve, oops, I think it's in that forest, is now also moving to attack the Russians from behind. So hopefully we can get them in like a bias here. That being said, the Russians seem to be seem to have numerical superiority. The weather is slowly starting to clear up here. Not 100% sure that our advantage or disadvantage. Now I'm here at the village where we're pushing out the rest of the Russians. And here our attack from behind is hopefully gaining traction. That's my reserve platoon here. They have to attack over open ground. Hoping to take out these howitzers, because no matter how the battle is going, if I can take them out, I can use them in the middle, obviously. I think one I have already defeated. Yeah. Would be nice to get a direct hit on that thing. Well, close. That being said, the Russian attack, of course, here, I think they basically broke through. So that platoon of infantry is mostly screwed. There are some survivors here still holding out, but I think the Russians are through. And they actually offer a ceasefire, and I'm gonna take that. So, now we have 30 seconds left to play. And then we will see how the game values our effort here, if we get a victory or not. To be honest, it was kind of a draw. Although I think they probably took more casualties, although they did basically destroy one of our infantry. So it's kind of hard to tell. We will see. And total victory, okay, that's good. And I got a bronze medal. So, this is complicated. Let's see if I can make sense of it. Casualties. 73 for us, that's a lot. 27% of our force. They had 111 casualties, so it's a bit better, and more percentage of their force as well. And yeah, here we have a bunch of more casualties. Now what you can do in this game is somehow, one second, what is that? Achievements, yeah. Return to main menu, return to operation. Combat progress, I don't know what that is. Ah, view after battle statistics, and now you can actually look at everything. Now, if there had been tanks in this battle, this would be more interesting. Oh, I think this shows... Ah, okay, so yeah, they captured this area here from us, I believe. And we captured this, which is probably more a bit more valuable. Still, this is annoying. Now, if there had been vehicles in this battle that got destroyed, we could actually check from which direction they got destroyed and by what kind of ammunition. So that stuff is relatively interesting. But obviously, the only kind of vehicles here were these howitzers. So, okay, that was our first battle here. We will return now to the overview and see how it affects everything. Okay, and here we are on the overview screen, and for some reason, even though I'm pretty sure I took this, we retreated out of it, maybe because of Russian pressure, and they did get this one. So I don't know why they told me it's a total victory, because that doesn't seem like a total victory to me. But okay, we will see how we deal with this in the next round. As always, thanks for watching, have a nice day.